Okay, it's really pouring today, and I mean really pouring. I think it's been a while since there's been this much rain. Some people are already saying now, oh, they miss the sunshine. You can't ever win, huh? First it's too hot, causes forest fires and stuff. Now it rains too much. And what was going on today? I guess this was kind of interesting. I remember reading that story before where apparently in the US, people were having arguments whether or not there was some kind of problems with the border where there were too many people. Some were saying there was, some were saying there wasn't. And I remember somebody actually flew a drone and it showed you, I guess, there were a lot of people. Well, how about this, where recently it was flown again, where you see thousands of people, and now because of that, apparently the FAA in the US introduced a no-fly zone around the area. This one says, FAA grounds Fox News drones near where thousands of migrants are sheltering under a bridge. The Federal Aviation Administration instituted a two-week flight restriction over the city of Del Rio, Texas late Thursday, preventing Fox News from operating a drone that it had been using to capture images of thousands of migrants sheltering under a bridge as they wait to be picked up by Border Patrol. The FAA's website said that the temporary flight restriction over the Del Rio port of entry and the international bridge was put in place for special security reasons, but did not elaborate. In a statement, the FAA said the Border Patrol requested the temporary flight restriction due to drones interfering with law enforcement flights on the border. As with any temporary flight restriction, media is able to call the FAA to make requests to operate in the area. And apparently for that news station, they're arguing that they've been flying drones for months to document the situation and there's never been an issue. So they're wondering why now all of a sudden? Is it just because of this new picture which shows, I mean, that looks like a ton of people in terms of like thousands and thousands or whatever, I guess. So it makes you think in this situation here, is it about safety, like they say, security reasons and all that, or is it more about, I guess, capturing information that you don't want to be out there, so to speak? To me, that's a legitimate concern. It reminds me of that story here in Canada, the one with all the residential schools and all that. All of a sudden, they banned anything that flies over things like a residential school. In terms of, for example, even a model aircraft, like a toy, literally anything, a 1 gram drone is completely banned. And you would argue there, well, maybe they could have used the drone, basically scout out the area, find more, I guess, grave sites since people are investigating. So it's a concern there where if it is legitimately about security, that's one thing. But if it's just to block out people from, I guess, documenting the situation or the area, in my opinion, that's troublesome. And this sounded like a follow-up story from the one I read previously where, according to news investigations, they were saying the US accidentally, I guess, killed innocent people with a drone. And at first there was no official reports, but then from seeing things like pictures and all that, analyzing it, they're saying it was an aid victim. And because of that, I guess people are protesting drones, so to speak, like attacks. It says, peace activists protest at Niagara Falls Air Base over Afghanistan drone attacks. Peace activists were again outside the Niagara Falls Air Reserve Station Thursday protesting what they say is an airbase command center for drones carrying out attacks around the world. Whether there is or not a drone base inside the facility is something the 107th Attack Wing won't comment. In a written statement, the unit said nothing about its current mission. In 2017, the 107th changed its name from Airlift Wing to Attack Wing to reflect the change from flying C-130 Hercules cargo planes to MQ-9 Reaper drones. And just from what I read too, I think they actually admitted it eventually, that they targeted the wrong people, like they were innocent. And it makes you wonder again, with things like, for example, with how drone regulations are in many cases and demonizing a recreational person just flying it for fun or capturing footage. Here are the examples of people actually using them to like kill people and so forth. Yet, I guess for whatever reason, that's okay, but if people are using it for fun or just documenting a situation, nope, gotta ban them all. To me, again, that's a little disturbing, where if it's not about safety, it makes me wonder, well, what's the point of having it? If you want to focus on safety, then focus on safety, but just using it as a way to say, I don't like what you're doing, so I'm going to stop you, that doesn't seem right in my opinion. And the last quick thing I read, which is kind of crazy, apparently there was a mother who had her 2-year-old son in an airplane who has asthma apparently, and the child wouldn't want to wear a mask, and so because of that the flight attendant, I guess, ordered like the plane or whatever to be landed and so forth, and they actually had cops and stuff like in this situation. Like, wow, isn't that overboard? You can see, I guess this person's friend here says, hello, maybe we can get a flight attendant fired from America Air today. My sweet friend's 2-year-old son was having an asthma attack and wouldn't keep mask on because he couldn't breathe, and they turned the plane around and had police waiting to escort them off. A 2-year-old. Holy, is that true? Is that a little overboard there for a kid? Because according to her too, they're saying the boy actually had a test and he came out negative for the COVID and stuff like that. And I guess in another disappointing thing, the person here says, I'd like to say that not one person stood up for this mom on the plane. I can't even comprehend seeing an injustice and just sitting quietly. It is kind of crazy, isn't it? I mean, a 2-year-old? Is that actually mandatory for like the 2-year-olds to wear a mask? Because to my understanding, even here anyways, like in Canada, there's usually an age limit where a kid that young doesn't have to wear it. So that seems so overboard, turning the plane around for that, having police and stuff like that. Ugh, the world's going crazy in some ways, huh? Definitely no flying today. I guess it's time for the archive. All right, see you guys later.